Hello friends, my name is Keshav Jadhav and in this video I will explain how to solve linear programming problem using graphical method. After watching this video, you will be able to solve any linear programming problem having two variables using graphical method. So to understand this method, let us solve one problem. So this is given problem. Using graphical method, maximize z is equal to 7x1 plus 6x2, which is subjected to x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 4, then 2x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 6, where x1 and x2 are greater than or equal to 0. So this is the linear programming problem, and we have to solve this linear programming problem using graphical method. Linear programming problem is the optimization problem in which one objective function and some constant equations are given to us, and we have to find out values of x1 and x2 such that those values will satisfy these constraints and value of z will be maximum or minimum, depends upon given problem. Here it is maximization problem. So we have to find out value of x1 and x2 such that those values will satisfy these constraints, and if you put those values in objective function, then value of z will be maximum possible value. Now to solve this example graphically, we have to draw lines for given constraints. So first we will write this given constraint in the form of equations. So for first constraint, equation will be like this: x1 plus x2 equal to 4. So to draw a line, we will write this equation as equal to. Instead of less than or equal to, we will write equal to. So this is equation number 1. We can write second constant equation as 2x1 plus x2 equal to 6. This is second equation. Now we have to draw the lines for these two equations. So here, this is x1 axis and here it is x2. To draw a line for these equations, we need two points. So for constant equation number 1, we can find out the points. So if we consider x1 is equal to 0, then from first equation we will get x2 is equal to 4. Similarly, if you take x2 is equal to 0, then we will get x1 is equal to 4. So for x2 is equal to 0, we will get x1 is equal to 4. So we will get two points. First point is 0, 4, and second point is 4, 0. So these are the points for first equation. Now for equation number 2. We will find points. So we will find points for equation number 2. So let us take equation number 2. In this equation, if you put x1 is equal to 0, then we will get x2 is equal to 6. So here we can write, for x1 is equal to 0, we will get x2 is equal to 6. Then if you put x2 is equal to 0, then we will get 2x1 is equal to 6, means x1 is equal to 3. So for x2 is equal to 0, x1 is equal to 3. So we will get two data points, that is 0, 6 and 3, 0. Now for these data points, we can draw lines. Now in these data points, maximum value is 6. So here we can take a scale on x1 axis and x2 axis such that we can locate these values. So let us take scale on both axes as 2 cm is equal to 1 unit. So here we can write for x1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly on x2 axis, we can write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we can locate these points. So let us take equation number 1. So for equation number 1, first point is 0, 4. So x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 4. So for x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 4. So this will be the point 0, 4. Similarly, second point is 4, 0. So x1 is equal to 4, x2 is equal to 0. So x1 is equal to 4 and x2 is equal to 0. So this is point 4, 0. So here we can draw a line for constant equation number 1. Now here for constant equation number 1, it is less than or equal to 4. So if you choose any point on this side of line, then this constraint will be satisfied. For example, if you take this point, that is x1 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 1. So if you put x1 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 1 in this equation, it is 1 plus 1, it is 2. So it is less than 4. So this is feasible. Or if you take any point on this side of line, then this constant equation will satisfy. Whereas if you take point on this side of line, that is, let us consider this point, x1 is equal to 2 and x2 is equal to 3. So here 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. So this constant is not satisfying if point is on this side of line. So this side of line is the feasible region and this side of line is not feasible. So any point on this side of line will satisfy the constant equation number 1. Let us draw a line for constant equation number 2. So points for constant equation number 2 are 0, 6 and 3, 0. So first point is 0, 6. So x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 6. So x1 is equal to 0 and x2 is equal to 6. So this is the point 0, 6. And second point 3, 0. So x1 is equal to 3, x2 is equal to 0. So this is the point 3, 0. Let us draw a line for constant equation number 2. Now here also this equation is less than or equal to 6. So if you choose any point on this side of line, then that point will satisfy this equation. For example, if you take this point, so if you put value of x1 and x2 in this equation, that is 2 into 1 plus 1, it is 3. So this point will satisfy this given constraint. Whereas if you choose any point on this side of line, for example this point, then this constraint will not satisfy. For example, if you take this point, x1 is equal to 2 and x2 is equal to 3. So 2 into 2, 4 plus 3, 7. So this constraint is not satisfying. So feasible region for the second constraint is this side. Now here, this is line for constraint number 2. And this is line for constraint number 1. So if you consider this region is feasible according to second constant equation, but not feasible according to first constant equation. Whereas this region is feasible according to first constant equation, but not according to second constant equation. And this region is feasible region according to both constant equation. Now additional constants are x1 and x2 should be greater than or equal to 0. So we cannot take negative value of x1 or negative value of x2. So x1 is greater than 0 and x2 is greater than 0. So this is the feasible region. So we can highlight the feasible region like this. So these are the corner points of the feasible region. So let us consider this corner point A, this B, this C and D. So ABCD is the feasible region. Now we have to go for optimality test. In optimality test, we have to find value of Z at each corner point of the feasible region. So let us write the value of x1 and x2 at corner points of the feasible region. So first point is A, which is 0, 0. This point is 0, 0. And objective function is Z is equal to 7x1 plus 6x2. So if you put x1 is equal to 0 and x2 is equal to 0 in this equation, then we will get 7 into 0 plus 6 into 0, which is equal to 0. For point number 2, that is point B is 3, 0. So x1 is equal to 3, x2 is equal to 0. So value of Z will be equal to 7 into 3 plus 6 into 0, which is 21. For point C, now here we can see value of point C is x1 is equal to 2 and x2 is equal to 2. So this point C is intersection of these two equations. So point C we can also calculate by solving these two equations simultaneously. So if you subtract equation number 1 from equation number 2, then here x2 x2 will get cancelled and we will get x1 is equal to 2. And if you put x1 is equal to 2 in this equation again, then we will get x2 is equal to 2. So in this way we can get value of C, value of intersection point of this line from graph, or by solving these equations analytically. So value of point C is 2, 2. x1 is equal to 2, x2 is equal to 2. So Z is equal to 7 into 2 plus 6 into 2, which is equal to 7 into 2 is 14 plus 6 into 2, 12. So 14 plus 12, 26. Similarly for point D, which is equal to 0, 4. Point D is 0, 4. So Z value for D point is 7 into 0 plus 6 into 4, which is equal to 24. Now these are the values of Z, that is objective function, at corner points of the feasible region. And here our objective is to find value of x1 and x2 such that value of Z will be maximum. So at point C, value of Z is maximum. So here, this is the solution. So in this way, we can solve linear programming problem having two variables using graphical method. Thank you for listening.